Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. And today, I'm going to show you how to build a computer. We'll turn this empty case into a spaghetti dinner. But first, a little about me. My name is Michelle. I am 8 years old and in second grade. I like slime, pizza, and Barbie dolls. I have a cat named Wilber.
Hey, that's me.
He has his very own show on my channel. We've been buddies since I was a baby. I have other videos too, like the ones that I make fun of Matthew McConaughey, Sorry Matt, and my show called Bus Stop. Make sure to hit that subscribe button and turn on notifications. If you like this video, give us a big thumbs up and leave a comment. The parts that we used are listed below. All you have to do is follow along. If I can do it, you can do it. Make sure to watch till the end for some special notes. Here's what we'll be using. A case to put everything in. Motherboard. CPU. Memory. Hard drive. For the power, we'll be using a flux capacitor, 1.21 gigawatts. Just kidding. Here's our power supply. Mouse and keyboard, fan splitter, a magnetic screwdriver, and this is optional. See this wristband? It's so you don't give the computer a shock. It basically grounds you without getting in trouble. You'll see me wearing it in a little while. You'll need a USB drive like this one to install Windows when we're done. More on this later. Okay, let's get started. The motherboard is the control center of the computer. It allows all the parts to communicate with each other. Here's a diagram I drew. It shows everything we'll be plugging in. Inside the box is the I/O shield. And this cable connects the motherboard to the hard drive. Save this disk for later. More on my notes at the end. Be careful handling the actual motherboard. There's pins underneath. We're gonna work on it right inside the box. The CPU is basically the brain of the computer. It stands for Central Processing Unit. It receives data and carries out instructions. That's real slime, by the way. I like slime. My friends like slime. Everyone likes slime. Except Mom and Dad. Push down on this lever, move it to the side, and lift up to reveal the socket. This is probably the hardest part. Putting the CPU into the motherboard. It's important to hold the CPU by the edges. You don't want to touch the pins. Okay, see this arrow? Match it with the arrow on the motherboard. This kind of reminds me of the game Operation. When installing the CPU, you must have a steady hand. Just gently set it in. Good. Make sure the arrows are lined up. Pull the lever back down to close the lid. Don't worry, that black piece is supposed to come off. It's really hard to close and it feels like you're gonna break it. I had to get my dad to do it. So don't be afraid to ask for help, especially if your dad's a nerd, like mine. Next, we're gonna install the CPU fan. It already has thermal paste on it. Just line it up with the holes and drop it in. Pushing down on the screws will lock it into place. And then plug the fan in here. Memory. What is it? I don't remember. Oh yeah, It stores data for the CPU. Memory is also called RAM, which stands for Random Access Memory. Our motherboard has two slots. It supports 32 gigabytes. We have 8 gigabytes, so we only need one slot. Open the clips on each side. Make sure the memory stick lines up. It will only fit one way. Push down, it should snap into place. Now it's time to install the motherboard into the case. There's a screw at the top and bottom, and the side panel will slide off. This box has a bunch of stuff we'll need, so take that out. Whoa. It contains the rest of the screws and some zip ties. The case manual will tell you where they go. Take the I/O shield that came with the motherboard and place it in the case. Don't bend it. If you're not sure which way it goes, use the motherboard as a guide. Now I'm going to wear the wristband. Lower the motherboard into the case and line it up with the I/O shield. There's only one way it can go. The motherboard already sits on a peg, so we only need 3 more screws. That's 1, 2, 3. Just make sure the motherboard is snug. The power supply sends electricity to the computer. This one has 650 watts. You can go with less, but if you want to upgrade down the road, you need a strong power supply. We had the fan facing down, because there's a vent on the bottom. Make sure it's flush against the case. And put the screws in. And flip the switch to the dash. Otherwise, your computer won't turn on. Hi, Wilber. How's my little buddy doing? The hard drive stores everything. The operating system, programs, your personal files, even when the computer is turned off. Technically, this is a solid state drive. It can hold 250 gigabytes. It slides into one of the slots here. Just make sure it snaps into place. Tighten the screw and add a second one. Time to start connecting everything. Let's get power to the motherboard and the CPU. The large plug has 24 pins. It goes in the motherboard, right next to the memory. The CPU power cord has 2 separate plugs, both 4 pin. Just use one and leave the other hanging. It goes at the top of the motherboard, above the CPU. It's hard to put something in the wrong spot. Just match up the shapes. Let's get power to the hard drive. One end goes in the power supply and the SATA port. The other end goes in the hard drive. Just match the L shape. Now we need that cable that came with the motherboard. That will connect the motherboard to the hard drive so they can talk to each other. Again, match the L shape. One end to the hard drive and the other to the motherboard. There are 4 ports to choose from. You can pick any, but we chose port 0. Let's connect the case cables. HD audio goes here, where it says F audio. USB 3.0 goes here. This part is really tricky. These connectors go where it says front panel. They are very small and difficult to put in. There are positives and negatives. The arrow means positive. My dad had to help with this part. There's a printed diagram on the motherboard. Remember the cable I showed you earlier? It's a fan splitter. Plug that in right here and connect it to the fans. So now we have that spaghetti dinner I promised.
I know it doesn't look pretty, but everything is hooked up.
There's a couple things you can do to tidy up. You could use the zip ties, but that's still messy. Or open the other side of the case and hide the wires that way. We're all done. Time to see if this thing works. Start by plugging it in. Earlier, I showed you this USB drive. You need to put the Windows installer on it. That's a whole other video. So plug in that USB drive. Get the mouse and keyboard ready. And their USB plug. We don't have the right monitor, so we're gonna hook it up to a TV. This is it. The moment of truth. Are you excited? Now we're gonna see if it works or not. Huh? Nothing's happening. Yes! It works! Go ahead and celebrate! You earned it! Now we have to install the operating system, Windows 10. It controls all the activities and programs of the computer. On the first screen, click Next. Then Install Now. You can register Windows later. So for now, we're just gonna click, I don't have a product key. We chose Windows 10 Home. Then click Next. Check this box. Then click Next. Click on Custom. Install Windows only. The hard drive should be highlighted as the install location. Click Next. Windows will do its thing and restart. Time to install Minecraft. Thanks for watching. Here's my challenge. Ask your mom, dad, parent, guardian, or someone special to build a computer. It's fun. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please hit the like button and subscribe. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments area. Now here's the special notes I was talking about. See you in the next video!